Heading in towards the land of dawn, getting and kicking off these playoffs, it's Blacklist International versus BTK. Your players are lined up and ready. The composition being brought to life on the main stage. Is everybody ready for some Mobile Legends action? Because I cannot wait for this game to start.
No one can wait. Honestly, let's just get right into it. The drafts are set. The players are ready, and so are the viewers. Let's get into the Land of Dawn for game number one, where Fly Chicken is already in a bit of a trouble here.
I mean, he knows what he has to do. He's got to absorb that pressure, and Oheb, he really needs that level one to work out for him.
I want to say for Blacklist International, this Estus and Harith combo, this has been so successful. If Estus alone is 100% win rate, I'm pretty sure that sometimes it Blacklist International already lost with the Estus, but Estus plus the Harith, that is such a scary combination.
Very, very scary combination. The thing is, for BTK, they want to isolate their targets, but you're going up against Blacklist International. This is a team that knows how to force their game onto you, their style. It's so hard to get out of that Blacklist code, but let's see what happens here.
Yep, I'm already seeing that Mobizane is getting attacked here. Fried Chicken as well as Shark sticking nearby. Good thing that Fried Chicken does have Renner out.
He triple wants sweep,
that
triple sweep.
No, he's... Oh, he actually does! But Oh My Venus manages to purify it out in time. Oh! Shark looking for the kill. He finds it. Oheb wants the punish, but there's only so little that he can do. A great start. A first blood by Razor coming in from BTK.
Holy moly, I just mentioned it, man. BTK, they want to isolate their targets, and somehow, some way, they were able to do it. That was insane, Wolf.
Yeah, bottom lane, you already see the trailer for Blacklist International. Surely BTK was able to get a kill up top, but that they spent so much time and so many resources up top. Blacklist International just thought, okay, let's straight bottom lane. So much Outer Dirt Energy Shield's gold going in favor of Blacklist International. Almost taking it all of it. Almost taking all of it, I mean.
Yeah, no. Honestly, I really like what BTK is doing here. But so far, let's see how this plays out for this turtle fight. Feathered Airstrike already getting on top of Zia here. Forcing the black shoes immediately. We're all saying the triple sweep to take out Oh My Venus. As they continue to fight, double kill coming in from Mobizane. Edward will trade for one, but it's a little too late. Flying Chicken is gonna stay on top of Shark, doing God's work, locking down the right heroes.
Man, oh man, are we seeing magic miracles happen here at the first game? I mentioned it earlier, you're giving away Blacklist International's comfort picks. If you're able to win, that is a huge, huge mental, you know, basically a mental win against this team, man.
100%. I mean, you get, what, two kills? And total of 3 for Mobizane, 2 kills in that specific dash. On top of the fact that they were able to get a turtle, that's a lot of economic advantage that BTK was able to have. Of course, they were also able to alleviate some of the pressure top lane as Fire Chicken got a little bit of a, you know, a breather up top. Now he's gonna be meaning the brunt of Blacklist International up top lane again. But Oh My Venus, once he gets level 4, now Blacklist International can group up. That ultimate is gonna just amplify the sieging potential of Blacklist International if ever.
I mean, sieging potential is looking all good here, but we need to talk about the scaling here because I think Blacklist International has got BTK beat in that department, right?
Absolutely, but I want to point out a fact that look at Victor. He has Tank Emblem here. It is very, very interesting as BTK, they're already going to go for the dive.
Here they go. Mobizane already immediately into the back to try and get off top of Haji, who manages to purify out of it in time. The Feather Airstrike is able to push the rest of the team back as Oheb walks forward, already popping the Zaman Force to look to get Zia. It's just a little too late here. Oh My Venus keeps the team healthy and topped off, but Edward now going up against Victor. Victor actually winning out on this trade so far, but Edward, the longer this goes, the better it is for the Esmeralda.
One thing you have to take note about Blacklist International, when they play, you always have to look at the minimap. And in fact, Blacklist International quietly was able to get a turret in the bottom lane. Well, this is because of the fact that Victor is a Cho, and Cho is not good at defending as much, specifically because he did have this tank emblem. Just interesting because as an XP laner, maybe that's arguable, but normally when you're a side laning Cho, you want that assassin emblem so that you can move faster around the map. You also deal the damage or a kill threat. Whereas when you only have the tank emblem, you're like more of a team player.
Now, coming over to this neutral objective here, Edward is just walking up. There's nothing much he can really do about the situation. Turtle already being slain by the SCB. Azia now getting punished for Feathered Air Strike in terms. With the help of the Zaman Force, Edward continued to just give vision for the team. Are they not going to punish him? Yes, they do. The Numenon Blast, as well as the triple sweep, going to be taking him out. Fried Chicken in position for the fight, finally. But you can see the respect here for the side of MobaZane, for Purifies. It's working out great, but when BTK says all the ultimates on one guy, that's when you see the damage.
Honestly, I really like what is going, but look at that. Another fight breaks out, and Oheb gets picked off. But I do want to talk about this, man. BTK, they've been playing extraordinarily well to their strengths, to their winning conditions. They know that in a brawl, a skirmish in the early stages, Blacklist will not be able to fight.
Wait, bottom side's already getting dove on towards Edward. They've used double their ultimates, Way of the Dragon, as well as the triple sweep. They managed to get the kill, and now they will trade turrets here. Okay, so it's worked out. They finally got the even side on the turrets. Flycheck and getting tapped by the feathered airstrike. Can he get out of this situation as Oh My Venus tops up Haji here? We see Shark moving up. He will be able to defend this.
Two things that BTK used. First is the shotgun as well as the initiation coming up from Shark up top lane to take out the killer on Oheb. That's amazing. And now BTK also put the pressure onto the bottom lane with a 2-3 total cross-map play. Now, the three-man gank sword in the bottom lane able to get a kill under the turret against the Esmeralda. That's amazing. And they also took advantage of the turtle buff. One thing that we always, like, not notice, when you're going for turtle plays, you get that shield allows you to dive.
What? We didn't get to see the action. I just saw for a quick second they find it, but hold on, Way of the Dragon into the Numenor Blast onto Edward. It doesn't hit on Edward, but it does get on top of Oh My Venus. Really doesn't matter. Wrong target priority. Triple sweep taking out Oheb straight away. Zio using the black shoes to get out of the situation, and now zones out the rest of the team. Yes, this is working out great, and BTK playing for other win conditions other than MobaZane, who's just snowballing and allowing them to take this turtle. Blacklist backs away.
This is beautiful from BTK. They are playing it so, so well. And this is the thing, right? Usually, we mentioned that Blacklist International, they have a way of just forcing their playstyle onto you. But even then, when Blacklist got the pick, when they're forcing a 5v4, BTK, they play with the vision, they play with the win conditions, and they're gonna go for more.
Again, Edward taking so much damage. Numenor Blast is gonna connect. No, just a little short moment. They can't go a little bit more. Victor fights away in the dragon. He doesn't have enough damage to take out Edward as the feathered airstrike is gonna drop his Oheb already with Zaman Force. Going to zone the rest of the team out. Haji losing a majority of his health. Deadly catch to disengage. They finally take out just Victor.
Yeah, Blacklist International, very good pincer maneuver to punish Victor. Then again, you have to say BTK really this bit of more than they could chew, right? Unfortunately for them, however, we're able to get a turret up top. So that's at least a trade when it comes to the kills into a turret. BTK, man, they're not even stingy at all about this ultimate for MobaZane. Every time that it is off cooldown, they just straight up use it. And you see them use this kind of tactic with their Balmer in the jungle. Surely it's two totally different heroes, right? Balmer is more of the tank, but they're playing it almost similarly as they want to group up. And so far, they have amassed 1,000 gold lead.
Yep, Zia getting picked off here already, but now they're going to initiate on towards main. Yes, they find the kill on towards my godlike coming in. Fried chicken coming in with Bennett's rage to zone the rest up, but Oheb wants to turn this so badly. Drops gets taken out immediately. Oh my goodness, the damage from Beatrix.
I love how they're playing this. BTK, they know exactly what to do in these fights. They don't win in the initial fight. They need to prolong it. They need to look for these one-one, isolate their members even in the team fights, and so far they're just so successful at doing so. And look at it, another pickoff coming in.
Yes, the chaos is working out well as Edward using the falling star moon to disengage from that fight. They're trying to defend this orange buff as much as they can as Wise collapses back. Victory here, maybe they're looking for initiation here, but it's not looking like a very good angle. They back away, but that's what they want. The snowball is working well for BTK.
Now they have 3,000 gold lead, especially that kill onto Wise is just so good, as well as the follow-up on the kill onto Oheb. Oheb is 1-3-0 now on this Harriet and Fly Chicken. I mean, that's, how about we call him the American Sniper for now on?
Yeah, he's doing an amazing job. I'm not going to lie. I've never seen so much damage come out of Beatrix so quickly as well. Now BTK hovering around the mid lane. Maybe they can maybe push out Blacklist International, split them up like you once said, Miracle?
Yeah, absolutely, man. You can see, all right, there was basically everyone said, MobaZane, focus on MobaZane. But right now you can see Fly Chicken, he's stepping up, man. He's using this Beatrix to a very high level at this point. You can see the positioning for the team as well. Even in these like crazy skirmishes, they are all so well organized. The front line is always at the front. BTK, they know how to do that. And look at that already.
already, it is already a 3,000 gold lead. Look at the cross map play, actually. Yeah. Bottom side, two of them pushing it out, forcing Edward to actually go and deal with the situation down there. Mid lane's getting shoved out to clear out the way for this Lord, maybe. Yeah.
Both of you guys have mentioned about the formation, like the overall map positioning for BTK was okay because they were able to like, out macro Blacklist International for now.
Oh, Numenon Blast coming on in, but Shark is gonna get hit backwards here. Got his Bulwark to try and protect himself, but his Oheb already dropping the Zaman Force. That's four ultimates, 4-2. This is a great position for BTK to take away the Lord. Blacklist International, are they looking for the re-engage here? This might not necessarily be their fight. BTK decide to back away.
Now you can see,
I mean, the Feathered Airstrike is coming up, but Zero takes the Black Shoes to move on out of there. Both sides, a little hesitant there.
Yeah, absolutely. You can see, actually, for the side of BTK, right, the items are starting to make a difference for Blacklist International. We mentioned the scaling, and now it's coming into effect already in the 10th minute of the game. Blacklist, they've secured a lot of defensive items, and this is where the Saber starts to fall off.
One thing that Blacklist International excels at is controlling that Lord, or the neutral objectives we're talking about, right? The Turtles and the Lords, they are best at forming around those pits. And most importantly, retakes are great.
The retakes already finally gets hit by the last hit of the sweep. And they also find Oheb at the same time. It's a 3v3 situation. Deadly Catcher trying to get them out of there, but Victor, he wants more. He's already hit them with a G. Can they catch it? The conceal is out. Shark lands on towards Wise gets taken out by Lilia. Immediately, the doom and gloom is more than enough. But Haji does not have the damage to finish off to get the trade kills. Boba Zane takes away goodness. Purple.
In this point, man, BTK are already tanked up. In fact, they were able to just get those Athena's shield. And my god, Victor, we were talking about how not effective this tank emblem is, but the reason why BTK remained on top of Blacklist International was because of that emblem, and he's even tanking up with Radiant Armor. Victor, my god, this is such an interesting take on the side lane, Cho.
Hey, Gideon, Wolf, I finally know what BTK means. It means break the code, because they've been doing it, man.
I love it.
They're speaking a whole new language of Mobile Legends. You don't usually see the Saber come out that often these days. And this is the one few situations where this snowball that usually falls off is working out. Blacklist International has to hold on to this aggression. The snowball needs to end at the very least. Get them an advantage. Yeah. Get them an inhibitor turret.
So this is not an enhanced Lord because they took down the Lord before the 12-minute mark. In fact, maybe 2 seconds before that. But they still will try to push.
This is unheard of. 7,000 gold lead against Blacklist? Look at how they're sieging as well. They're playing it so smart with White Chicken basically just using his abilities right now to go in. And they're splitting the map once again, isolating the targets while they go for the siege.
Yep, and even without the minions, they are going to break open the bottom as well as top inhibitor, getting tier 2 from the mid lane as well. White Chicken is going to continue his onslaught. Blacklist have to do something. Feathered Airstrike coming up. Zia in trouble. He manages to get out, not even having to use his Black Shoes. BTK have a huge 9.1k overall gold swing.
BTK, they have learned so much, and this is not an understatement. BTK, they have literally evolved in a day, in 2 days, right before the playoffs. What is this? We didn't see this level of game back in the group stage. We saw them actually, some teams were actually able to just dominate them from the start. This is unheard of, especially going up against Blacklist, man.
One of the keys to victory for Blacklist International is to watch out for pocket strategies or pocket picks, and BTK, my god, this is just maybe one of the tricks up there, you know, bag of tricks. With the Saber, not only that, they put on Victor on a tank emblem, Cho, from the side lanes. It's out of this world, man. Mm-hmm. If you think about it, I mean, if you see this in your rank games, perhaps, or maybe if you see it in some of the amateur tournaments, you're going to laugh at it. Why are you picking the Concussive Blast and the tank emblem at least, and even tank up when it comes to itemization from a side laning Cho? I just can't believe it.
You gotta believe it here. I mean, Victor has been, you know, in terms of draft, usually he's not winning his lane, and he has to kind of play for the team here, and I'm pretty sure even Victor himself is like, I'm sick of this. Give me something good. Give me a Cho. I'll walk with the tank emblems, and I will make something happen. Haji getting hit for 50% of his HP,
God.
But don't worry, my Venus, he's going to top him off. The siege is going to be good. However, this upcoming Lord, I want to see how BTK kind of handles the situation.
At this point, it's time to talk about the mental pressure, man. For the side of BTK, they have no pressure. They're coming into this confident. You know, if we lose, we're losing against Blacklist. Everyone expects them to win. But if we win, we're going to break the code. And there you go, another endgame!
Oh, Numenon Blast landing. And already on my Venus, having to purify out of the situation to break open. Oh, Olaf in some trouble here. Shock looking for an opportunity to get the last hit. But it's not going too well as the rest of the team now break them open.
Zia!
They are seen. They find it. Zia has done it. They found the darkness. And now, can they actually end? No, there isn't any minions just yet. And 27 more seconds until Lord BTK disrespecting it, knowing that they have an 11k gold lead here. Zia, he still has the black shoes, walks on up, takes it over. Edward doesn't have the items to do anything just yet. They're looking for the end. They already kick on to Haji. They're going to end it on top. BTK have done it. They made their statement. The West has caught up. That's game number one going over to BTK.
Upsets after upsets after upsets. We thought it was because of the best of one. They've done it again. Break the code.
The code as we roll at least for one game. Imagine this. Blacklist International get the chance there.